Last week, I talked about using Airtable to track your debts and therefore derive your net worth from those debts and the payments that you've made. But that's not the full picture, is it? Because we didn't even talk about cash. We didn't talk about cash in and the most important asset for most of us, our most liquid asset, is cash. So how can we include cash into our financial understanding and include it in our Airtable database? Well, in this very video, I'm gonna break down how I've done that. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, a business that's set up to help you to organize and automate your business using no-code tools. So if that's of interest, before we get into the actual video content itself, if you'd like to learn more about leveraging no-code tools like Airtable and specifically automation, definitely check out my upcoming webinar. On this webinar, I break down for you the basic building blocks of automation using no-code tools. You don't have to know a single line of code in order to leverage these powerful tools and start saving up to 20 hours of your time per week thanks to automation and better organization. So if that's of interest, do check out that link below. Visit me at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration to get all signed up. And even if you cannot attend the live event, you'll get a replay sent to you so you can always check it out. But without further ado, let's hop into the actual heart of this, where we're gonna be building on the idea that we can track our finances here in Airtable. Now, real quick recap, last week I put out a video that looked at these three different tables. So we're not gonna be talking about them too much again here today. Specifically, we dropped into cash out, amortization, and then assets. Now this is where we're tracking the payments on our loans and thereby deriving the equity that we own in the various assets under our control. But for this particular video, you'll notice that we've branched out and included some new tables. So I have cash in, income source, and cash position. So let's break this down so that we get a better understanding of how we can use Airtable to track our overall cash position. Now, before I jump into it, I do want to point out that I had to add a new formula in the cash out table. So if you followed along from the last video, we had the payment amount here and we had additional principal, but nowhere on this table were we summing that to calculate the total payment that we were making. And of course, this is the total cash outlay for us every time we make a payment on a debt. And so I had to add this formula here. Pretty straightforward, we're just adding those two pieces. The payment amount, that is the amortized payment amount, plus any additional principal that we paid towards that loan principal when we made that payment. Okay, simple enough, straightforward. This is our total cash outflow every time we make a payment. So let's now drop into cash in. We'll get started in the beginning. So every time cash is received by us on a personal level, it's coming from a specific income source. Now for many people, that income source is just their employer, their job. But for several crazy folks like me, we have multiple income streams. By the way, I strongly recommend this just on a personal level. If you can develop additional income streams, it will significantly improve your overall net worth. So for me, I've just listed out a couple of different example income streams. These are income streams that I actually do have, but I'm using example data. So Built to Scale is my company where I teach people how to become consultants of their own. And so I'm saying, hey, look, I have that particular income source and then I bring in money from that income source. Now this is a business. And so of course I'm taking profits from that. So whether you're actually paying yourself a salary from your business or you're just taking an owner draw on your business, whichever way you're handling that, entirely up to you, if in fact you run your own business. Otherwise, all we're really trying to track here is that income is coming in and you're receiving a certain amount of income, right? And so for every record of that, we have to have a date. When did we receive that income? We have to have the source of that income. If it's just your job, that's great. But if you have multiple streams, go ahead and denote them here. By the way, this is tying to our income source, which we'll look at in just a minute. Then, of course, you have a payment type. Now, if you want to break it down so that you can track different streams even more granularly, for example, in my case, I run Gap Consulting. Well, sometimes I take profits in the form of development work. Other times I take profits in the form of course payments. And so you can break these things out so that you get an even more granular perspective on the different income streams that are bringing money and adding to your net worth. Now we're also, of course, going to have to denote the amount of that cash in position, right? So however much money came in, if it's your job, by the way, quick pro tip, if you are receiving cash from an employer and it's on a consistent schedule, you could always build an automation to automatically create the cash in for you. Simply set that automation up on a schedule. For example, on the 1st and the 15th of every month, I want to create a new record here, assign the date, and link it to the income source of my employer and put your, you know, salaried amount in there if you have one. So again, there are a lot of ways that you can hack this and make it a little bit smarter and easier to use. Now, let's talk really quickly about income source, and then we'll go into cash position, which of course you see here is linked as well. So income source is a really simple table. It just includes the different sources of income, and then you're linking back to them. And the reason that you would want to do this is in case you ever want to see how much money you make over a given period of time. For example, you could calculate your totals, and in doing so, you would just use a roll-up field type here and apply the roll-up to the cash in link. Of course, you're going to look at that amount and run a summation, and this is going to give you real quick glance of how much money you're producing from your various income streams. So breaking them out into its own table like this is going to be really beneficial for you if you want to track your progress across multiple income streams. Now again, going back to it though, if you only have one income stream, you can pretty much ignore this table. Don't even worry about it if your income's only coming from one place. Now, for the tricky part, we have cash out and cash in, but what we need to know is what is our total cash balance look like? So we need to combine both of these pieces in one table. And the easiest way to do that is as follows. We build a link here in our cash position table, and we link it to our cash in table. Remember, cash in is income received. We're then able to look up, using a lookup field, we can look up the date that the cash in came in, right? Because every time we record cash in, it has a date and an amount. And so here we're able to track the amount. Similarly, we're using a lookup field to look up the amount through the cash in link. Now, part two, we're also connecting here to our cash out table because we want to see cash in and cash out in the same table in a way where we can use a very normalized version of the variables. Specifically, we're looking at what's the date and what's the amount, right? Cash in, cash out, date and amount in each case. So here again, we need to look up that cash out date. So similarly to before, we're using a lookup field. This time we're looking at the cash out and we're looking at the date paid for that outlay of cash. Similarly here in our amount out field, we're doing the same thing, looking at the total amount. Now in this case, what we need to know is, well, if it's cash in, then I need a date. Because it doesn't help me to have some dates here in the date in field and then some dates here in the date out field. So it's a lot easier if I'm just looking at all my dates in one place. The best way to do that, write a formula that says, hey, if there's a date in, then show me the date in. But if there's not, then there's probably a date out. So show me the date out, right? Simple enough piece of logic here. And we write a similar formula here for the amount formula, because again, it doesn't help us to have amount in one column and then other amounts in another column. So what we want to see is if there's an amount in, remember this is income, then I want to display income, amount in. But if there's not, I want to display the amount out, but I want it to be negative. So I'm multiplying it by -1 because amount out is cash that's leaving our bank account. Okay, so now we're able to, at a glance, see all the cash and all the dates. So now that I've got this all built up, all I have to do is hide those extra fields. I don't need to see date in, date amount, date out, and amount out. All I want to see is what's it linked to, and I could even hide this to be even easier, but specifically what's the date and how much cash came either in or out of the account. Now, what I'd really like to see here is all of this grouped by year and month, right? So I want to see it all grouped chronologically, essentially, so that all my cash in or out is grouped within a certain month so that I can kind of get a better perspective of how things are flowing in and out of my cash position. So in order to do this, I can write a year month formula. I'll be referencing the date field here, and I will simply say, take that date field and apply a specific format to it. date time format to that date field. And the format I want to use is a 4-digit year with a dash and a 2-digit month. Go ahead and create that field. And now I have a nice little formula here that I can use to get a better perspective of. So here I can go ahead and group by this field. And now I can see bunched over time how my cash position is doing. Here's the month of September. I only had cash in. Wouldn't that be nice? Here's the month of October. I only had cash in for my example data, right? And so you can quickly see how you're doing in any given month. Apparently here with my dummy data, I only have cash out planned for December. So this is going to be a tough month. Now for me, because your cash position is so different from your net worth, I'm not actually linking my cash position to my assets. If you wanted to see your cash position here with your assets and actually add that to your net worth, again, assets is something we talked about in the previous video, you can definitely do that. But I really do think about these as two separate things. My assets are those things that are growing my net worth for me almost in a passive way. And my cash position is my buying power. It signifies how liquid I am, but I don't really count it all that much in my overall net worth because, frankly, it doesn't contribute that much to it. Again, for you, if you want to take that to the next level, you can always link your cash position to your assets. I hope you got a ton of value out of this video. If you really like this, I will be making this template available for you. Check the links below this video for instruction on how you can get access to that template, and I will see you in the next video. As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.